Seven demonstrators that passed their trials. Manufacturers often supply trial units to operators in hope that they will end up purchasing multiple units. However, not all bus chassis pass the trials. In fact, only a small number do. The question, which we would very much like to answer in this video, is what is the most successful demonstrator? Let's dig around a little bit and find out. Number 7. The Volvo B10TL. SBS was supplied with a lone B10TL back in 1999 to test its suitability for service in Singapore. It received the most common body for the chassis at that time, the Vogon CR222LD. Despite the relative lack of power, SBS purchased 50 more in identical specification to the demonstrator. Delivery of the last chassis was delayed though, and for good reason. The bus was to become a bodywork demonstrator for ComfortDelGro's very own engineering firm. The successful build and deployment of the bus on service validated their ability to produce city bus bodies, a skill which they needed to apply to body up the first batch of B90Ls when they first came to Singapore in 2006. Number 6. The MAN A95. SMRT was pretty satisfied with MAN's single-deck offerings, so it makes sense for MAN to tempt SMRT into getting some buses from its double-deck portfolio too. Enter SMB5888H. The first MAN A95 to be registered, it shared a lot with SBS7777Y, the Gemilang B90L bodywork demonstrator. Currently, we have 81 A95s and a second demonstrator, which is 12.8 meters long and has 3 doors, registered as SG5999Z. My most favorite thing about the A95 is that it is equipped with a Entribeslung System, or ASR for short, which is German for traction control. Yes, German does sound a little spicier than English at times. Number 5. The Mercedes-Benz OC500LE. The OC500LE was the first bus SMRT buses purchased. It was after the trial of the demonstrator, SMB1H, was a success. The firm proudly advertised the fact that they were the first in Singapore to operate a Euro 5 bus, and that, coupled with the power of the OC500LE motor, made purchasing the first batch almost a no-brainer. A larger rear EDS was all that was needed to make the demonstrator production ready, although the specification was altered again for the second batch. Number 4. The Alexander, Dennis and Varro 500. Complain all you like about it creaking and cracking. The demonstrators, SMB5001A and SMB5002Y, impressed the correct people and passed their respective trials. Spec-wise, the demonstrator and production batches are pretty much identical. They are pretty similar, bar seats and the colour of interior plastics, to the British and Hong Konger counterparts too. 201 of these are currently on our roads, with a smaller second batch scheduled to enter revenue service later this year. Number 3. The MAN A22. As SMRT didn't find the OC500LE or the Citaro suitable for mass replacement, they had to turn to another manufacturer for a solution. MAN provided a lone chassis with bodywork by MCV Evolution and assembly by Suncho, which when put together formed SMB138Y, the A22 demonstrator. Whilst the chassis impressed, the bodywork didn't. As such, SMRT ordered the production spec A22s with MAN's very own Lion City bodywork. Just like the Citaro with SBS Transit, they ordered so many that post BCM, LTA has had to inherit their order. 734 A22s operated by two companies ply the roads today. Number 2. The Mercedes Citaro. SMRT was initially given a UK spec Citaro for evaluation purposes. Whilst they didn't think it was a suitable candidate for fleetwide expansion and replacement, with some light modifications to the specifications, SBS Transit did, and ordered so many that LTA actually ended up inheriting the orders after the transition to the BCM. As of today, the lone demonstrator impressed so much that combined, all four operators have a total of 1,090 units spread out across two different specifications and a whole host of liveries both permanent and stopgap. Number 1. The Scania K230UB. The KUB could have very easily been replaced by the next big idea when it came to the value-for-money city bus. However, it didn't, unlike the MAN 18.204, Volvo B7RLE, and the Mercedes-Benz OC500LE that came before it. SBS Transit trialled a Gemilang-built demonstrator, which bore more than just a passing resemblance to the European-built Scanias of its time. It impressed, although its quirky purple interior didn't. With some toning down, and a switch to some Vogel seats System 750s, 1,100 units, 500 of which are Euro 4 and 600 Euro 5s, were added to the fleet. Again, the KUB reigns supreme. Hate on it all you like, but ignoring its rough edges, it is a pretty solid bus indeed. Thank you for watching another TOUGHX video. Do subscribe if you haven't already. Also, here's a little announcement. Currently, we need help to decide what we want to do for the 140th episode. So do pop over to the link in the video description and suggest something which you would like to see for said episode. Also, if you enjoyed the content and have a few bucks to spare, you can go towards funding more insane and wild episodes of more things in the future in the ko.fi link in the description down below. Thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye. The other side.